What is going on, guys? Jason Burke here, Styles Clash for Life, coming at you on YouTube, and today I've got some football focus. I'm sorry this video is going up a little bit later than usual. Usually I get my Steelers Sunday reviews up a few minutes after the game is over, but I watched this one with a friend when the Steelers played the Raiders yesterday in Week 14 of the 2018 NFL season. I correctly predicted this one as a loss. It is the Steelers' third consecutive loss, heading into the toughest portion of their schedule of the season. And many people are saying this is the end of the Steelers season. People are saying this is it. To barely survive against Jacksonville and then to come along and lose to a lesser opponent in Denver, and then to blow a big lead against a great opponent in the Chargers and lose that game, and now to come in to a 2-10 team and lose here. When we still have the Patriots and Saints ahead of us, this seems to be a good possibility that our season is over. For whatever reason, I just had a bad feeling about this game all week. I correctly predicted a loss here. Pittsburgh always struggles in traveling to Oakland. I don't know if it's the West Coast traveling, the difference in time zone, just the trap game mentality with the Raiders being 2-10. But Pittsburgh has always struggled there. Ben's road record against Oakland, playing in Oakland, is 0-3 in his career up until yesterday. Now he's 0-4. So he's never won a game in Oakland. I think Derek Carr beat us once before. I think Terrell Pryor, when they were like 2-10, beat us once before. So we just always struggle with this matchup in particular. And with the slide we've been on, after the Denver loss and blowing the Chargers lead for a loss, I just thought this was going to be a quintessential trap game for us. We were going to lose. What makes it even worse for us is that all the other big AFC contenders lost yesterday for the most part. Baltimore had lost, so we had a chance to gain a game on them in the AFC for the AFC North Division, which would have been huge for us. A lot of the underneath teams lost, like Houston added their skid. Who else lost yesterday? The Patriots lost to the Dolphins out of nowhere. The Broncos lost and ended their recent consecutive win streak, as the Texans did. So many teams lost yesterday, leaving us open for a potential number two seed in the AFC. If we had won yesterday, we would have gained a game on pretty much everyone in the AFC and been right outside, been about one game outside of the two seed. And now we're being talked about as being not in the playoffs at all, in spite of still leading the AFC North by a half game. Baltimore's schedule gets a lot easier. Ours gets tougher. So we're sitting here now with a record of 7-5-1. I've got several reasons to blame this loss. Number one, coaching. The play calling for this team has been bad week after week, especially in this game with Jalen Samuel being in there. Just very predictable play calling. Ben was really conservative, being called conservatively. A lot of times going to the empty set on third and shorts, so you're taking the option of the runaway from the teams, not really giving Samuel much of a chance to run when he was in there. Then, of course, Ben got injured, and Josh Dobbs played for like four or five series, and they went with the traditional run-run pass, or if it was third and long, they'd go to an easy screen. So very conservative play with him as well. I understand that it's a third-string running back and a backup quarterback at times, but you can't do the run-run pass thing, because if I can call the plays and I know what's coming up, the opposing defense knows what's coming up as well. Credit to the Raiders' defense for covering our receivers pretty well. Lots of good breakups. Ben was throwing the ball high yesterday. So was Dobbs. But the Raiders' corners played our receivers very well. Only one guy had a breakout game offensively yesterday. Everyone else was held pretty much in check. So good job to the Raiders' defense. Much credit to them. Derek Carr slung the ball pretty well yesterday. I didn't get the Raiders' stats, but he flung the ball in there pretty well. Hit lots of tight windows. He capitalized on our biggest weakness, which is our linebackers trying to cover their tight ends. So Jared Cook did what he always does. He had over 100 yards on us. Covering tight ends is our biggest weakness. Middle of the field tackling and linebackers on coverage are a huge weakness for us. So congrats to Derek Carr for squeezing the ball in there. Jared Cook played well. Seth Roberts caught a few balls. Jordy Nelson did a nice job in victimizing Cody Sensabaugh on us. He had his biggest game out of all the Raiders receivers. But again, coaching, just time management, keeping Ben out of the game when Ben was apparently able to go. When he came back in the late second half, Tomlin said Ben was able to play, but he kept him out for conservative reasons. He wanted to make sure he didn't overuse him. Meanwhile, when you're only ahead by 4 points, one possession, against a 2-10 team, when you're fighting for a playoff berth and a higher seed, you don't leave your Hall of Fame quarterback on the bench. Number two, when the Raiders drove down the field with 1:20 left, and we could have called timeout to get the ball back and give our Hall of Fame quarterback a chance to drive the field again, Tomlin did not call timeout and let the clock run down to under 20 seconds when the Raiders scored the go-ahead touchdown. So I understand you don't want to give the Raiders a chance to get set, but they're going to score anyway. Our defense sucks. Our defense is garbage, and to let our Hall of Fame quarterback, who just drove us down the field, not have 1.5 minutes to do it again and not using our timeout is stupid, irresponsible, dumb gameplay, and Tomlin deserves to be called on the carpet for that because that was horrible. And even still, even after Ben drives us down for the touchdown and our defense gives up another one to the Raiders, Ben drives us back down the field with a Juju Smith-Schuster hook and ladder play to get a chance to tie the game with a field goal, drives us down in 20 seconds thanks to Ben and Juju, and then Boswell slips on the field and misses another field goal, has it kicked right into the guy's butt. And so we wind up losing this game 24-21. So props to Ben, props to Juju. They were the two guys that played biggest yesterday. But Boswell was 0-2 in this game, missed both field goal attempts, and also had an extra point ricochet off the goalpost that happened to fall in. So he missed two field goals and almost missed an extra point that bounced off the uprights and got lucky enough to fall on the right side of the damn goalpost. So I understand the field was slippery yesterday. Oakland's field is kind of known to be trash, but to have the season Boswell's had, missing all these extra points and field goals, I know the field's slippery. I know Switzer was slipping all day yesterday on returns, and he's not doing anything on returns, by the way, either. But Boswell's had a terrible season, and this field goal wasn't even close. Like, the Raiders didn't even block this attempt at a tying field goal. This bounced off Alejandro Villanueva's ass cheek. This thing was so low and wouldn't even have gotten 10 yards down the field if it had gotten over our linemen in the first place. So Boswell, someone we look to be firing at the end of the season. He's a possible guy to be losing his job or at least be challenged for his job next preseason. Keith Butler deserves to be fired because this defense has no heart. Aside from coaching and aside from kicking, looking at this defense in general, they have no heart. That's like four times this season that they've allowed guys to come down and score game-tying or game-winning touchdowns in the last, like, minute of the game. They've let these guys come down in less than a minute and go ahead with these scores time after time after time. The coverage of this team, you know, Burns obviously got benched already. He's gone at the end of the year. Sensabaugh's not playing much better. Hilton is a good cornerback who has good games, but he gets burned on some big plays. Even Hayden has his moments. The pressure, happening to blitz three guys all the time. Why are you blitzing three guys when you're one of the sack leaders and your defense goes from 32nd to 12th when you blitz? So, ridiculous. Oakland gave us every chance in the world with over 10 penalties and over 100 yards in penalties yesterday, and we still blew it. So, ridiculous. And again, two turnovers, minus one. So losing that battle again as well is a problem. Discipline for this team. Tomlin needs to be called on the carpet. Keith Butler needs fired. Boswell needs fired. A lot of guys on this defense need fired. We need better linebackers. We need a second cornerback. And we need better blitz packages as well. So we need a lot of things on this team. Looking at the stats really quick, Ben was 25 of 29 when he was in there for about 2.5 quarters. 282 yards, 2 touchdowns, no picks. So he was a little high and erratic at times, but overall, 25 of 29, played a good game. Stephen Ridley did get a 1-yard touchdown. Good for him. Didn't do much for the game. Juju is our offensive MVP. He's the only guy on offense who truly brought it yesterday. Big game, 8 catches for 130 yards and 2 touchdowns, plus the big hook and ladder play that almost got us to tie the game at the end of the game if Boswell didn't blow it. Defensively, I give credit to Mike Hilton. He was all over the field yesterday. 6 tackles, a sack, and a fumble recovery. He was our MVP on defense far and away yesterday, even though he did get beat on the go-ahead touchdown. So he's been getting beat a little more recently in coverage, but he's a very good nickel cover guy, and he gets in the backfield a lot. Both Dupree and Stephon Tuitt had a sack, and Javon Hargrave had 3 tackles, 2 for a loss. So Hargrave continues to play well. Tuitt with a sack and a batted ball plays well, and Dupree got a sack yesterday. He's kind of been inconsistent all season. So lots of guys to to worry about in this future. We've got to see where how to get a third wide receiver out there. We got to figure out how to get a second corner out there. We got to get better kick coverage. We got to get better defensive play calling. Better cornerbacks, better coverage linebackers. We have a lot of issues on this team. So we're now 7-5-1, and we have the Patriots next week and the Saints following that. So this team is in trouble and in danger of losing the division and maybe even losing a wild card if we don't win at least two of these games coming up, because we're looking at 8-8-1 or 8-7-1 or whatever the hell the record is. 8-7-1 if we can even get one more win out of these next three. So what do you guys think of this game? Who do you blame and who needs called on the carpet? Tell me in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys next week.